We live, we work, and we move, and everything is on one plane. And we're finding that traffic is getting worse at an exponential rate every year. There's just an inherent limit to what we can do moving around on the roads. So we're looking to the sky.
Mark Groden has always looked to the sky.
So I grew up in the Midwest, and through grade school, I moved 13 times. And that meant that a large part of my childhood was sitting in the backseat of a car, looking out the window, just very frustrated with the state of transportation. I became really passionate in aerospace engineering when I was pretty young, because I recognized that aircraft could one day potentially provide a mode of transportation that would really revolutionize the way that we got around.
He took his childhood dream of flying over traffic seriously. When he was 16, he invented an unmanned aerial vehicle for the Air Force, and then went on to get his PhD in sensor data fusion. And in 2016, when he was 26 years old, he founded SkyRyse.
Mission of the company is to make air transportation accessible and safe for everyone as a new mode of transportation. One day to replace terrestrial modes of transportation.
The company has raised $25 million and has grown to a team of about 20 people who come from SpaceX, Boeing, Airbus, and NASA.
Somewhere in the span of 5 to 10 years, it will be possible to request an aircraft that's vertical takeoff and landing capable to a location not too far from your origin or your destination. Once you get to that site, you board the aircraft pretty swiftly and take off and fly to your destination. And the cost of that mode of transportation will quickly move to rival that of, say, Lyft or Didi. And that's the future.
Groden says they have the technology to make this future possible. But for now, SkyRyse is testing its system in helicopters to gather data.
We're developing systems to reduce the cognitive load on pilots. So specifically helicopters, a vertical takeoff and landing aircraft like a helicopter requires constant input by the pilot. I can't hover a helicopter. I've tried a couple of times. It's very challenging. It's like rubbing your belly, patting your head, and then keeping a beat with your feet all at the same time.
So SkyRyse developed technology that can help. It added sensors and cameras to make helicopters safer and easier to fly in tough conditions like fog. To start, the company partnered with the city of Tracy, California, by building its system into Tracy's first responder helicopter.
Right now in the helicopter, we have an enhanced vision system, which just gives you an increased amount of situational awareness. So it's a 360 camera. There's also an active radar system in there, which coincides with the terrain avoidance system that we already have in the aircraft. And it's something that most civilian aircraft that I know of don't have. You know, accidents are caused almost 99% by pilot error. So if we can find a system that prevents pilots from having accidents, I think that's pretty exciting.
So we're flying first responder systems in our operation. Just last week, after 5 days of operating, we had responded to over 22 calls and even done a mission with the FBI. We were frankly surprised at how much we were able to add to their capability and getting to a scene quickly. We were on scene faster than all ground units for every single 911 call last week in Tracy.
The company will use the data collected on board to improve autonomous flight capabilities. But SkyRyse is not the only startup that envisions a future with flying taxis. Companies like Volocopter and Uber are working towards the same goal.
Last I heard, Uber suggested that they'd be launching their system in 10 years. We expect to be launching far sooner than in 10 years. We are already flying today with technology on board aircraft in missions and in Tracy, and that's something that we know of no other company within this technology space doing.
Another big difference, SkyRyse is not planning on building an aircraft from scratch.
We're starting with a proven airframe, and we're putting systems in that airframe that is going to allow us to, I think, reach the ultimate goal faster and better.
But even when the technology is ready, there are other hurdles that could get in the way.
There are a number of things that have to happen in order to enable autonomous air transportation, kind of in this air taxi capacity that we're all envisioning. Public perception needs to be there, so people need to be comfortable with having aircraft flying over their heads and being inside of them. Then there's a regulatory aspect. So the FAA and other regulatory bodies don't yet have the regulations needed to even consider autonomous flight. And so getting to that point of actually having regulations that are written to approve technologies like that is a huge component. At SkyRyse, we're not a self-flying aircraft company, but we're building the technologies that could one day lead to aircraft that fly themselves.